extremely powerful. Religion, either as a political tool or something that can bring us together, and the example of the historic debate could not be more to the point. So thank you so much, sir, for joining us. My understanding is you're going to run to London, but thank you so much. We really do appreciate that. Next, it is my great pleasure to introduce Ms. Elisabeth Cook, who is the Vice President of UPF Austria. And in December 2019, she participated in the World Clergy Leadership Conference in New York. And today, she would love to share some information with us about that.
Good afternoon, Glances, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to share a few impressions of this conference, which I could participate on. A small delegation of Austrians actually participated on the 7th, and a few of us are also here today. The conference was actually a really big-scale conference with more than 1,000 participants from all around the world. Also, Europe was represented with around 150 participants from Austria, only 7, but from other countries more. And the venue was also very interesting and very exciting. It was right in the heart of New York, in the New Yorker Hotel. We just stepped out of the hotel and you could see the Empire State Building, so we were really excited about this whole conference. The World Clergy Leadership Conference is actually a continuation of another organization which has been existing for 20 years in America. It is called the American Leadership Conference, Clergy Leadership Conference. It was founded in the year 2000 as a coalition of clergy working to strengthen marriages and rebuild families. Their commonly shared hope is, as they express, to lead all humankind into becoming one family under God. The idea is behind that the Christian communities, which are also quite divided and don't love each other so much from time to time, they should strive to unite and accept each other and then reach out to other religions and build bridges and relationships. We go right into the conference. The gentleman here on the right-hand side, Dr. Lauren Rose, he was the MC, he's also one leading figure in the American Clergy Leadership Conference, and he spoke about the importance of clergy at this time, and he highlighted, and he was really happy to see that most of the world's faiths were represented at this conference. And the gentleman beside him, a Korean gentleman, the chairman of Family Federation of North America, he stated that when we look at the world, we see nations and leaders centered on their own interests, and we see division within the religious world. As religious leaders, it is our responsibility to overcome these divisions. We must unite under God's love, which is greater than our differences. I chose this quote because it shows somehow the spirit behind the conference and behind the work they have been doing for 20 years. It was really a very colorful picture. There were speeches from representatives of many different religions, and the good thing at this conference was that although it was a large-scale conference, each speaker had only a short time to speak, maybe 5 minutes more than we have today here. So many representatives could share their ideas or give their contribution. This was the conference at the beginning. Everybody stood up for an opening prayer, of course, and many dignitaries, many religious representatives and guests from all around the world. This is from the balcony, so you can see it's really a very big group and a very interesting and impressive group. The Austrian delegation was represented by Dr. Manuel Aydin as a speaker. He is core episcopus of the Syrian Orthodox Church in Vienna, and he spoke about the importance of family values and also about the Christian situation in different countries of the world. His speech was well received, and it was partly translated by a German gentleman, Dr. Schmidt, because Dr. Eiding's English was not so good. Then we had a representative, another representative from Europe. He may not have been born in Europe, but he represented the World Council of Churches from Geneva. So, Reverend Dr. Peniel Jesudasan Rufus Roy Kumar, he gave a very, very interesting speech, and I wrote one quote of him, which I thought was very interesting. We need to teach our children how our history and future is bound with others. We need to let ourselves be pulled by the spirit of the divine in unexpected ways. I think this is very interesting because we also are at the beginning of a new decade, 2020, and maybe we need to be pulled by the spirit of the divine in unexpected ways. The American continent was represented by this gentleman, Prophet Samuel Adebe from South Africa. And the reason why he spoke was because he had been traveling with Mrs. Moon, the founder of also the ACLC, in Africa last year to various countries like Senegal, Niger, Tanzania, where he helped organize peace rallies, where Mrs. Moon gave the keynote address. In his own country, in South Africa, he rented the biggest stadium in Africa, the 100,000 people stadium, which he filled with people, with his followers partly, but also with other people. And then he invited Mrs. Moon to give the keynote speech, and she also gave a special peace blessing to all the people who were there. So at the end of the day, there was a peace declaration being signed by all the participants, and a promise that they will cooperate and work for peace and understanding among the various regions. Here are a few other photographs. This gentleman, you see one gentleman from Austria on the right-hand side, Reverend Arthur from the Celestial Church of Christ, and these are also more Austrian participants. Dr. Aydin, Magister Maria Palmer, UPF Vice President from Upper Austria, and this is Christine Meyer Lumitzberger, also from Upper Austria. She's also here today. And the colorful gentleman is a Catholic from South Korea. That's the way they dress in South Korea. So, yeah, some more representatives. The young lady beside the representative from the World Council of Churches is a reverend from Prague, and she represents the Hussites Church. She also was a panelist and gave her speech. Yeah, then after the first day, the second day, we all had a chance to participate in a big rally which took place in the Prudential Center, which was just outside New York. And it was a Peace Starts With Me rally. Maybe some of you remember this graphic, Peace Starts With Me. We had a similar rally in Vienna in 2018 in the Stadthalle. Maybe some of you participated. And this time, the difference, it was a similar rally. The difference was that this stadium was made for about 20,000 people. So the Stadthalle can take 10,000, but this rally was a rally for 20,000 people, and it was filled. And you see the person standing and giving the speech, Mrs. Moon, she looks quite small in front of these 20,000 people. But she gave her speech appealing to the Christians to unite in the spirit of the gospel and not to emphasize the differences between each other. And she also shared some of her experiences because she and her husband spent 34 years of their life working in America, working for the revival of Christianity and Christian family values, especially appealing to the young generation. So, at the end, she also signed this declaration of the World Clergy Leadership Conference, the founding of this organization. So, before the speech and after the speech, there were cultural programs going on, the 2,000 people's choir. And for us Europeans, it was really interesting to see how the Americans, especially the black communities of America, approach their faith and their beliefs. They seem to do it much more from the heart than from the intellect. And this enables them also to generate more enthusiasm for their cause than what we usually produce when we believe in something. And we felt, oh, maybe we should take something from this to Europe and put it into our lives as well. So the rally, people were just getting up, singing along, dancing along, shouting something out. And they were so happy. Nobody except the European corner, we were sitting quietly to see everybody really serious, almost crying, and thinking, what does it mean what she says now? Whereas the Americans, so we were really then thinking about this again, how they do that. So, and we were quite inspired, and our hope is that in Austria we can also found maybe an Austrian Clergy Leadership Conference where we can generate a hopeful and joyful spirit. Anyway, then the last day we had a chance to do a sightseeing tour. This is part of the European group, only a small part. And the first step, the first stop, which took us to the memorial of the World Trade Center's destruction, the Ground Zero. It was really quite tense to stand there and see this memorial where this is a deep basin and a hole in the middle and the water is flowing into the hole. It's normally a spring, is the water is coming out, but here it's going in. And we couldn't but pray for the people who had lost their lives there. There's one basin here and then another one just beside. Finally, we could get a glimpse of the Statue of Liberty before we headed back to Europe. And it was our wish to, as I said, to launch a similar organization in Austria and in Europe. And we hope that many of you can participate or contribute to this means, to this tool of building bridges between religions and denominations and thus contribute to peace in Europe. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you so much for that, Elisabeth, and I do love being pulled by the spirit of the divine in unexpected ways. That's something quite beautiful. Now, we have one more presentation today, and then